Welcome to the Ready to Love Season 4 Episode 8 review. This is Couples Couch with
Pat
and I'm Cam. Let's get into this week's episode. If you are looking for this week's episode, the name of this episode is called The X Factor. In your DVR, it will show up as Season 3 Episode 8, but it is in fact Season 4 Episode 8. Apparently, the new temp had time today and decided to update the correct episode number, but failed to update the season number. So I'm just letting y'all know from the gate. Season 4, Episode 8. If you are new to our channel, welcome. If you are not new, we will only give a high-level overview of this show. We do not get into the nitty-gritty details of every last thing that happened. Only what's important to the storyline to the show for each couple. So let's jump right into this week's episode. So the show opens up with the ladies arriving to Tommy's house. This is, I guess, the new ladies' lounge for this episode. Apparently, Papacito's was closed for construction, and they were not taking guests, so they had to show up to Tommy's house for the ladies' lounge. There, they met with Tommy's wife. She greeted them in. Tommy came out strutting like an old man, talking about, who these people in my house? Nevertheless, the ladies walked in. Alexis talking about she was trying to touch everything. Like, this is how I want to live. So I was trying to put my, you know, I was trying to touch everything. And this is why people don't want guests to put your fingerprints all over my glass. Like,
exactly why I don't have
sitting on my pillows, my good pillows, just flattening my stuff out. This is why people don't want guests over. We just want to keep our house the way it's supposed to be.
I agree. Everybody in this house knows what you can and cannot sit on, use.
And that's how our stuff stays. Yeah.
Go ask some kids to use the towels in the bathroom to dry their hair.
My kids know those are for decoration. You want a towel? Go to the linen closet, get you a towel. Yeah,
gnaw off their own hands before they dry them with them towels.
So anyways, they show up to Tommy's house and they sit and talk about how they have the power this week to eliminate. And Tommy wants these ladies to have their exes meet up with the guys on the show so they can get insight from somebody who knows them and who is close to them. So that's what they're supposed to do this week.
That's going
to
be a no for me, Tommy.
So this week, Tommy no wants the way. Ladies to introduce the men to their exes.
Nope, not doing it.
This shall be a very interesting episode.
Y'all are getting introduced to my homeboy's wife. Somebody I know is on my side. Ain't no way you gonna talk to my ex. She's unstable. That's why we're not together now.
Let's dive right into seeing how these dates went down with meeting up with their exes and the guys. I'm very interested to see. First up is Vernicia and her ex, David. They're at a restaurant waiting to meet up with Joelle. Joelle shows up to see Vernicia at the restaurant.
Looking like the train conductor on the little engine that could.
And he's like, you know, hey bro, what's up? Like, he don't know who this dude is at the table, has no clue. And he finds out that this is Vernicia's ex. And he was like, bam! Her ex is here. Like, I didn't know what to think. So they dive right into conversation, and Joelle goes right in asking her ex, here's the question I have for you. I need to know the answer. Is Vernicia clingy? And he's like, no, she's not. And he was like, okay, that's good to know. And I think that question was stemmed from their falling out last week's episode, which we did not see. But now we get the full story.
We get nothing near a full story.
Okay, now we get part of the story on what happened. So apparently, Vernicia and Joelle had plans to meet up for a date to go out to eat. I guess Joelle had plans and told her, like, hey, we can meet up at whatever time, said time, and if something, you know, if there's a change of plans, I'll let you know. Time went on and on and on. I guess the time went past when they were supposed to meet up. Vernicia hit him up and was like, hey, are we meeting? And she said she was hangry at this point because she hadn't eaten. And she hit him up like, what are we doing?
So she called yelling and probably screaming. To admit
some kind of way.
You were angry.
Yeah.
She could throw hunger in there if she want, but she was angry, is what she's saying.
So Joelle automatically took that like she's clingy because he's like, yo, I'm trying to live out here and you getting on my case about where I'm at and what I'm doing and when we're supposed to meet up, apparently.
You don't have chips in your house? You could get no Cheez-Its. Stick of cheese, nothing. No snacks, an apple.
To hold you over it.
Banana, nothing. You don't have nothing to eat.
I would have ate and just would have met up with him. I'm not going to starve myself if that's the case. You know what I mean? But
no, she ain't starving.
I see her point.
She
you
got
right.
Wingdings and ho-hos, Twix. You're not lying. Come on now.
So, David, Vernicia's ex, played the neutral role. He was like, I ain't getting in this. He was like, do y'all think y'all could have handled this differently? So he played mediator, you know, but a neutral party. And
he was dressed for it. He had on the white linen shirt, six buttons, barely hanging on.
You know, I can't. So
motorcycle jacket, no motorcycle in sight.
He said, do y'all think y'all can handle this differently? And Joelle was like,
we definitely can handle this differently. I don't know you. Why are you coming at me like this?
He's not coming at him no kind
of
way.
Coming at me like this.
He's not coming at him.
Why are you here?
I actually like.
Why are you here?
This was one meetup that I liked.
Why did you invite him?
They were adults, and I was here for them being mature adults and having a good conversation. I'm not about to let you spew no negativity on this meetup. It was a good, decent meetup.
Right. And if all of them are going to be good and decent, then I don't need to watch any of them. That's not what I'm here for.
You see how obvious he is. I think they had a good meetup. Joelle said that he could have done things better. He could have communicated better. And that was pretty much it. He thanked David for being here to help him out. Vernicia's like, he helped you. He was helping me. And Joelle's like, nah. He helping me to make a decision. He's like, all right, D. Don't turn it into D now. Said it. And I enjoyed that. That was a good little. I enjoyed that. Like, that gave me all the feels.
What if you got a call tomorrow and your ex wanted you to come and meet some girl he's talking to? Would you go on the show? And would it go like this?
Are you saying if my ex asked me to
go
on the show?
Not your real ex, but in theory an ex.
I got you. And you're saying for me to go on the show to defend him.
As an ex.
Yeah, to defend him.
You're supposed to give your opinion.
Well, I'm going to have to speak facts. Would you?
No.
Let me say it like this, and I'm going to give real people. If I had to go on a show to talk about Patrick to another girl, y'all see how he acts. So, I mean, I could bring myself and our over 5,000 subscribers with me to talk about how Patrick is.
Because
what you see here is how this fool acts.
First of all.
All the time.
Any female I'm willing to be seen on national TV with has been vetted and knows how I am. So there's not going to be no surprises.
And with that being
said, I'm just going on TV with some stranger with her judgment? You crazy as hell.
But we need all of yours.
Yes.
I'm moving on to the next scene.
That's why they clicked on this. Like, I didn't go to their door. Ding dong. Hey, they came here. This is what they want.
I'm moving on to the next scene. Let's go see who the next meetup was with their exes. Next scene shows Ron meeting up at Alexis's house to meet up with her for a date. He does not know that he's gonna meet Alexis's ex-boyfriend or just ex. So he comes in the door and he sees him and she's like, yeah, I want you to meet my ex. And he's like, oh, okay. But here's a catch for me. Did anybody peep that she had him meet his or her ex-boyfriend instead of her ex-husband? So there was an ex-husband, then the ex-boyfriend, and then whoever else down the road, you know?
Right. Cause
why was the ex-husband not the ex that we met?
Because he got some damn sense.
He's like, I'm not doing this with
this
y'all.
Stupid shit.
Not
for what? What do I get out of it? That's what you would have to convince me. That's
why I said no. Why wasn't it her ex-husband who did?
That's why I wouldn't go. If my ex asked me to come on this show, I wouldn't go. Not because I hold anything for her. Like, what do I get out of it? Just to come on there and, no.
I go on there and talk about Couples Couch. Be sure to follow us, like, subscribe.
I'd be one big infomercial.
Me too.
You're like, so is she clingy? Well, I think you really have to watch Couples Couch to get my idea of what clingy is. And if you like it, subscribe.
And be sure to drop a comment in the comment section. It would all be a big infomercial. Anyways, we digress. Okay, so Ron shows up, sees Alexis's ex-boyfriend. They all sit down for a conversation at her house. And her ex-boyfriend brings up, like, how do you handle conflict and stuff like that? He's like, I argue like a man. I argue with logic. That's where he lost me. He's like, why you gotta say it like this, Ron? Then he says, and then Ron asked the dude, the ex, so are you a religious guy? And,
no.
And he told the dude, I could just feel the religion coming off of you.
Yo, and Ron. I didn't agree with all of Ron's views.
But
in that moment, that's me. Like,
but that was rude to say to somebody you don't know.
But it's I don't mean it rude, okay? Because there's a certain way that I communicate. And there's certain language that I like to use when I'm comfortably communicating with somebody. So, to prevent me from putting my foot in my mouth too much, if through some birdie or some way I found out you may be into the church a lot, I might ask you, oh, so you like real religious, right? I don't mean no disrespect. I'm not, because if you're like, yo, I go to church, but I'm not like, oh, I don't go to Bible study during the week, then I could be like, oh, okay, what's up, bro? And keep it moving. But if you're like, you know,
yeah, I go to youth service, I go to marriage retreats,
right? Then I go find somebody else in the room to
church
talk to.
Church picnic. I go baby stand. Blessings.
I go over there.
Church. I'm just naming it.
God bless, brother. I'm gonna catch up with you later, all right?
Sorry, I'm just throwing stuff.
Yeah, that's exactly right, brother.
So Ron moves on to say to the man that he left the church because he just had a bad experience. I guess in his interview, really, he said, you know, he felt like the pastor was greedy. They trying to get you for your money. He just had he was jaded, like he said. And I'm not doing this with you. So he already came in the room with a bad taste in his mouth for church and church people. So
how much you make a year?
It was
what?
So it's gonna.
I came here for salvation.
It's gonna give him a
y'all
bad
charge.
I don't want to go down this road. I'm trying to do.
I'm not.
Well, you just asked them to charge for your salvation. I'm just.
Then why do they ask how much I make a year?
I'm not going down this road with you. So, anyways.
God knows.
Ron says that
ask him.
He never plans to grow into a super religious man. That's just not going to happen, and he don't want it forced upon him.
Now, that's why I disagree. Don't tempt him. don't challenge him. Yeah. That's
Ron
when I start moving
Alexis
over.
Is more of a put it in the air type of woman, you know, with her prayers and her beliefs. Mm-hmm. And he's the kind of person like, I'm out the door. I'm trying to go get it done.
Out the door where he needs you for that lightning bolt.
You don't want to get strapped. You don't want to get strapped. So he said he's not about to just sit around and, you know, wait on a blessing to come. He about to be out the streets. So what that my
you can do both
interpretation.
You're supposed to do both. You're supposed to do for yourself.
Hallelujah. Thank you. God help those who help themselves.
And I'm not.
God.
I'm not even.
Those.
I'm not. I'm not even all religious and stuff. And I know that.
You gotta have faith. You know, faith without works are dead. Like you have to do something.
Go. Keep it going.
Hallelujah. I'm just saying. I'm just saying. I mean, Ron.
We're just having fun.
You left the church too early. I think they was right in the middle about to tell you how faith works. And you left. You didn't get the whole. But you didn't get to receive the message.
See, you can't. Ron think he's slick. Ron is a slick talker, so you gotta watch it.
I'm sorry.
He said he left the church, but he ain't never said how long he was there for.
He went for a christening.
They passed the offer plate. He was like, oh, they after my money.
I can't do this. This is not what I came here to do.
You know what?
I left my AJ, no. You got my wallet.
Y'all take Apple Pay?
Him and AJ looking for their wallet together.
AJ go feel bad and go back a couple months later. Like, Jesus, you want to go out to a lobster dinner?
I'm going to keep on making makeup right at the pearly gates. I got yams, potatoes, and greens, beans. Sorry.
You know!
I'm moving on. What you got to go do?
I'm going to turn the air down. Y'all be here laughing, I'm sweating. Hunger no
more. Neither shall they thirst. And this is how Kamara be in church for real. For God shall wipe away. Yes, sir. Every I'll be like this. Yes, get ready for the revolution. What you say now? Whoa. Do you want a revolution? Do you want a
revolution? What are you doing? Harlem shake.
That was a Harlem spirit.
Next scene is a high-level overview. The ladies meet up for a hanging out date with each other at the nail bar. They make drinks that are named after the men they like. They get their feet done. They talk about who's into who. They all into the same people. And let's move on to the next scene.
I love it.
Next scene shows Liz meeting up with her ex, Clarence. In that moment, she tells her ex that off camera, David asked her, what did you do today? That time, last time when they met up with in front of his friends. And she was like, oh, I just did a little bit of this and that. And he was like, oh, but you didn't kiss Jason again, did you? And she said he did that or said that right in front of his friends, which took her back. Like, dang, I told you that in confidence. And then here you are putting me out here on Front Street in front of your friends. In front of your friends! And you know, that was embarrassing for her because she felt like she told him that in confidence, and she didn't have to. She also noted too. So Liz's ex, Clarence, was like, I don't like that either. So then here comes David, denim down.
You took that from me. She took that from me. I said that.
I woke
That's
up.
That's where we at. Stealing my one-liners.
I'm sorry. Here comes
I ain't
denim
telling
Dave.
You no more. I'm not telling you no more stuff. You gonna get it when they get it.
God don't like that.
That's right.
Ron, you watching this? I'm sorry. Snorting. Okay. So, Denim Dave walks in, as you like to call him.
Now you give me the credit after you done got caught for plagiarism. I've cited that down on page.
So Clarence asks David, says to David, it's nice to meet you, but I got some questions. And David was like, it's not nice to meet you. It's no longer a pleasure anymore.
Well, I got a question too.
Okay, ask the question before I go into what Clarence asked.
How do you get your beard and your hair like that? It's amazing.
It's beautiful.
I love it.
Isn't it gorgeous? Like,
that's a little too much.
Okay, sorry. Bring it back.
There you go. What was his name? Let it be Tyrone.
Clarence.
His name is Tyrone. Yeah. His name is Tyrone because ain't nobody's named Clarence.
Hey, Clarence. I'm just kidding. Okay.
Better shows with better contestants,
Clarence,
I'll get me one.
Listen, you know how I am. I hear them talking, but I can't take my eyes off of how gorgeous Clarence's hair is. And that side part was like fierce, and the beard was salt and pepper. I'm like, yo, go on and get old Patrick so you could get the salt and pepper, but you gotta cut all this off.
Yo, don't touch my hair.
It's wet.
You wouldn't touch it earlier to braid it. Don't. And that's another. Okay. You gonna sit here and talk about another man's hair after you refuse to braid my hair
in front of my friends?
In front of my friends.
Sorry, that was Liz. But yeah. So, anyways, so they exchange greetings. Let's get back on track. And then Claire's like, I got some questions. So how important is communication to you, David? And he's like, oh, it's tremendously important. He was like, okay, well, Liz shared with me that she shared with you something in confidence and you betrayed her in front of your friends. In front of your friends. And just played her out. Pause. I know Clarence was trying to do diligence for Liz by saying, like, you know, you betrayed her trust, but is he betraying her trust by now bringing the whole thing that she just shared in confidence with him, or was she doing his dirty work, her dirty work, to try to bring it up to him, like, yo, I didn't like that? Did you feel like it was a betrayal of a betrayal, or you just thought they was just hashing it out?
You want to know the truth?
Just tell me.
This is all stupid.
Okay, so let's get back to it.
Say that all this is over two kisses, probably 15 years apart. She wasn't even your girl for you to sit at this table and question me about if I'm a safe place.
Okay, you know what?
I'm not a safe
you
place.
You know what? You are on track.
Because, I know.
Because, no, you don't. Because before they got into this conversation about the betrayal of trust, David did ask Clarence, when was the last time y'all had a level of intimacy? And Clarence said, that was like years and years ago.
We had a kiss years and years. So you're not her ex. Don't rub my back. Thank you.
You have a problem.
Co-host.
I'm about to be your ex, talking about you on another show.
I'll talk worse about you.
We're going to go blow for
Let's
blow.
Let's go.
Hey, you can't remember half this. I got notes on you.
I don't even know my YouTube.
Anyways, we did press so much. We can't get through this. So I just wanted to know if that was a betrayal of trust. But apparently,
come on, I know you're mad at me. What's the password for my YouTube? Yeah, you don't have to like me. I just need to get into YouTube.
You sounding real Lamar.
I want to comment on your videos.
Anyways. So Clarence was like, you know, I'm just asking, do you feel like you're a safe place for her because she shared something in confidence with you? And he was like, I absolutely feel like a safe place. So that was to me, that was them trying to track him.
I got this right here. It says a safe place over here. What you gonna do, Clarence? Are you a safe place? I'm feeling dangerous. That's how these should have been.
Liz sat there with her face long, just looking sad and everything. Like, she wanted it to be talked about, but she didn't really know how to talk about it. And then, you know,
Liz sitting there, if they doing all this over some kisses.
Shut up.
Just wait.
Shut up. David says, I definitely feel like I'm a safe place for Liz. And she said she didn't feel the same. She felt disconnected from him due to what he did in front of his friends. And he started to lay on the compliments, thick and heavy.
I put you on a pedestal. Listen here, baby.
The platform I put you on, Liz.
Me and you can take this all the way, baby. I put you on a platform, baby.
Where is that from?
Every pimp
in the world. Yo, but I heard that somewhere. It was like Chris Tucker or what's that? Martin, or it's probably Martin.
Anyone that ever tried to play, no, that I think you are right. That is Martin.
That's Martin with that baby.
Baby.
I think that's Martin. That's hilarious. So she didn't feel like it was a safe place. Mm-mm. She didn't like it.
It's not. He's not a safe place.
She felt like he wasn't her safe place. Because he spilled the tea. That's like me telling you something and then you just walk out and just start talking about it. I'm like, yo, son, you're not supposed to say this.
It would be the equivalent of, you know, Patrick watches Golden Girls. It's a kiss. Not even a sloppy one. Like,
It was a peck. It was such a dry, dry kiss. But she felt some kind of way. But you know, when you're in front of your friends and you're trying to put on a certain image, you know, first impression, that's like me and your friends, and then you'll be like, oh, you wasn't out there kissing that dude like you told me you did last time. You'd be like, yo, son, you're trying to kill that
If we're dating and you was kissing the dude, your image is the last thing I'm worried about. I probably invited you on that date just to blast you in front of my friends. Look at you over there, old yuck mouth, slopping spit with any hoo nanny you can find.
Not a hoo nanny. Anyway, so David was like, yo, this conversation is getting very tense. How about we bring the strength down in the room?
You being here and her being here, I want to like just kind of bring down the strength in the room right now. Oh, because, yeah. I'm an alpha. I don't know how to be weak.
I just have a life process.
Yeah. Well, you're the only dumbbell here, so why don't you leave?
I never heard anybody refer to tensions being high in a room as the strength in the room. Let's bring the strength down.
It's because his computer was overriding. He's used to being able to just bolster his way through somebody else. And he saw the gleam in that man's eyes. He said,
"But then
I'm an alpha man." He said it calm, quiet, and collected.
I'm an alpha male.
I don't know how to be weak.
I was dead in my chair.
Well, I'm going to leave then.
He was like, all right, well, I'm good. Let's have a great day. I'm out. What are we doing?
You're no longer my number one.
As you give the number two.
With your old ass.
Peace.
I ain't never heard that, but I was here for Clarence's response.
Go on, ham over some geriatric uni.
I'm done. I'm done. And I'm not going to translate what uni means, but you know what he's saying. Let's move on to the next scene.
Ooh, na, na, na.
Next scene's going to be a high-level overview. Kyra meets up with Jason for dinner at her house, and she tells him that she wants him to meet her ex. They're meeting him virtually. They zoom her in onto her TV, and they have some dialogue back and forth about Kyra, who she is as a person, how she deals with conflict, how she deals with money, her money management skills. That was a cause for concern. For Jason, he was like, I hope she's not the kind of person out here be trying to like try. What is this supposed to mean?
Kyra's nose. They shiny.
Her nose is always so shiny. Why I think she just goes heavy on the bronzer or the...
She needs to do some powder. What's that?
Press powder. Blot. Blot your...
Look like she just got to
help
don't
me.
Don't start filming. I'm here. Whew. 3, 2, 1. Y'all right? Okay.
I can't.
My nose. But my nose.
I can't deal with you.
All right.
Anyways, her money management skills are a cause for concern for Jason. He's like, I hope she's not the kind of person that will, you know, blow all her money to go on trips and stuff and, you know, don't have money for others.
She can do whatever she wants with her money.
You're going to have to bail her out with some rent money.
Who going to bail who out?
He just wants her to have better spending habits.
I don't care what your spending habits are. You're going to learn. I'm not the one.
Jeez. Let's move on to the next scene. That was the high-level overview for that scene. Next scene, Amber and her ex are at a restaurant waiting for Chris to show up. Chris shows up. Meets Amber and is like, who's this dude? Harpo, who this dude? And she says, oh, this is my ex. And he's like, oh, okay. I feel like they all have the same, you know, reaction. So Chris reveals that he would like to have kids. He's like, I'd like a starting five, meaning five kids, but he'll take 3 for now. Amber reveals that, she would love to have kids. She actually wants to be a mom more than anything, even more than being a wife. Chris and Amber and her ex are vibing, having good conversations.
That's why we got baby mamas.
Stop.
There's got so many baby mamas out here. No.
Want to be a wife more than being a mom.
Be a family.
She wants to be a mom. Yes, be a family. Have that as your priority.
I want to be a mom. Some dudes be like, all right.
Jeez. Listen.
She ain't say she ain't want to be a single mom.
Listen. Amber, Chris and her ex, they're all having a good time talking and stuff. And Chris, like, picks up on a vibe. Like, they have, like, a really friendly vibe. Chris and her ex. I'm sorry. Amber and her ex have a very friendly vibe. And he's like, what's going on here? I'm noticing something's weird.
It did shock me. It did upset me.
Yeah. When we were together, I came out. I'm interested in guys, so I also like guys. And so she was literally...
And then Amber reveals that, yeah, I had a hard time. You know, he made me very upset, very mad about a certain situation. And then her ex reveals, he's like, yeah, I came out. I'm gay.
I knew that. I saw your eyebrows.
I didn't know. I would have never known. What I did pick up on was that him and Amber looked alike to me. That's all I could keep seeing. Like, why do they look the same? Like, they have the same features to me a little bit. Maybe same little head and little
blush.
It wasn't the blush. I'm just saying, they kind of reminded me of each other. So I was like, okay, that sounds bad too. That's not what I mean. But anyway, Chris was very relieved that Amber and her ex were not, like, together just because they had something they wanted to share with him.
Hell yeah, Chris is really, he's like, nobody on the show wants her. Nobody from the past wants her. I'm in.
I'm all the way in.
I'm in. This one is all me.
And that was
Skeletor is gonna win this round.
And Puma.
Skeletor.
Let's move on to the next
man.
Jason and Liz and AJ and Alexis meet up for a lunch date. Alexis reveals. Are you breathing? Why do I have to film like this? Like, it shouldn't be this hard. Are you alive? Like, what the?
No. I was stuck. I was thinking.
What are you thinking about?
No, I swear to God. So you're talking, and I'm trying to, I'm remembering what happened in the scene, and I'm like, this is what's going on. When y'all see me spaced out, this is what's going on. In my head, I'm like, yo, it would be funny if I got my mask and acted like when AJ went to pull her face to kiss, and I could tell Kamara, like, turn my face to the camera, and when I turn, I have my mask on, like, it's Corona. That's what I was thinking. That's what you caught. So it really be off the top of my, like, as we're going, I think of stuff. So sometimes you call, I got caught stuck.
You look like you were
going, I did,
to cardiac.
Once you said something, I'm like, my mouth does feel funny. It's because I'm holding it. Like,
what the fuck is going on? You will not die on this set. If you die on me, I'll kill you. You hear me? I'll kill you, anime. I am crying.
Yo.
I'm just,
I swear.
I am crying.
I was zoned. I was like, it's weird because I hear you talking, but I'm not listening to the words.
I am sorry.
I'm just sitting like. What would be funny here?
I shouldn't have to work like this. Under these conditions, I just shouldn't have to.
Yo, I'm telling you, ADHD, if treated right, is an amazing. Like, I just went off in my. I was into the scene. I was like, which mask should I wear? Like, my Black Lives Matter mask? No.
Okay.
I was going through.
I should. Like, my makeup probably looks insane now.
And what did you say? Are you going to breathe?
I was like, are you breathing? All right, let's get through this. Now that Patrick Dunn gave away the whole scene and you know what's about to happen, Jason and Liz and AJ and Alexis meet up for a lunch date. Alexis reveals that she's really into AJ, but she fears that he will break her heart. She says she doesn't feel secure with AJ because he hasn't chosen her. She said he is definitely the type that she could fall in love with because she said she likes Ron because Ron chose her. But you know, AJ hasn't chosen her. Alexis goes on a rant about making sure that the guy is there with his heart in it, as she should be there with her heart, and she keeps going on, and he goes, all right, hey, and he just lays one on her and starts kissing her, and she shut up immediately. She had nothing else to say. She was like, okay, then let me fix my hat.
But let's go back to her philosophy on why she chose Ron, first of all.
Because he chose her.
Right. And it goes back to what I've always said.
And he always says this, y'all. And I always used to think he was crazy until now Alexis has confirmed it.
Back when a person's single.
Yeah.
They should adopt this philosophy. I cannot and will not ever be with everybody I want to be with.
Okay.
But I can try to be with everyone that wants to be with me.
Okay. That's not what I thought you were going to say. When you used to ask Patrick about like his relationships in the past, he would be like, I'd be with her because she like me. Whoever like me, I like them. I'm like, how does that work? Just because they like you? If you like me, then I like you. Like,
it's better than running around like a lot of people liking people who don't like you.
That's true too.
You know, you just got over it somewhere that happened. It's a method to his madness. Have you standing there with a banana purse? All
right. And that was the end of that scene. Let's move on to the next scene. The ladies return back to Tommy's house for the ladies lounge. Papacito's is still closed for construction. They may have it open next week in episode 48. But until you don't know then, what number that's going to be.
Until then, they're going to stay at this nice
Airbnb that you swear is not Tommy's house. I'm it's just the Airbnb. Playing. It that's, probably is. He said they broke ground and everything. That's his house. So, stop. So, anyway, so this is the ladies lounge. They're back at Tommy's house. Tommy has some food prepared for them, so they eat and recap their dates that they went on with their exes and their guys for the week. Vernicia goes first. She said that her date went well with her ex and Joelle, and she was able to confirm that she was not clingy. Alexis talks about...
How do you confirm you're not clingy?
Because the dude confirmed it on her behalf. Her ex confirmed it for her. Remember, Joelle asked, I want to know this about
I'm
her.
I'm supposed to believe this dude? That's you like, didn't believe that's why you ain't.
You coming with your defenses up.
I'm supposed to believe a dude that you didn't believe and that's why y'all ain't together no more.
Alexis.
And guess what else happened?
What else happened?
He stopped liking her. That's why they don't talk no more.
Stop. Listen. So
if
she
he still liked her, they'd be talking still.
Let's move on to Alexis. Alexis talks about her date with Ron and her ex and how it hurt her to the core that Ron told her ex that he looked like he just dripping in religion. That bothered her. And how Ron also said he's not going to pray about things and that she can pray about things by herself. Tommy made a statement that if you decide to go forward with this, just know that you will get to this point every Sunday, meaning when church arrives, that y'all will come into this argument because he don't want it, you know?
No.
You don't have that faith. She was like, oh, you make a good point. And Tommy says you need to think about how if you want to move forward with this relationship that God may not be involved in your relationship. And that brought her to tears. And Tommy gave, you know, a little story about how.
Why the tears? Can somebody explain that to me?
Why her tears?
Yeah, why is she crying?
She just cried because it hit home that she may not have God in her relationship. And God is very important to her.
But why are you crying?
It moved her to tears. She's worried.
What part? The part that the guy you're in love with him now? Why are you crying? What are the tears?
It worries her soul. I don't know.
That a guy she's dating out of four other guys she's dating might not have got. Why are you
her
crying?
Her number one ain't who she thought he was going to be.
If you're ranking dudes, is that really your number one? Why
that's
are you
what
crying?
Tommy is. That's what Tommy's saying to her. Is he really your number one? Because you can't have God.
Even if he is your number one, you've been on the show for a couple weeks. Why are you crying?
Not everybody's I'm sick not of these emotional people crying. Like you. Not everybody's
no,
not
okay.
emotional
true,
like you.
True. I'm a rock. And I understand that everybody is. So I get it, but I need to understand in this situation, why are you crying? It goes back to the dude last week. They said nice Jason. Things about me. Does someone have to cry every episode? Do they pull sticks and whoever gets the short stick gotta cry? Why is she crying?
Okay, Tommy started to tear up a little bit when he spoke about how God was good to him and how the first thing he did was when he got that house broke ground and had everybody come and pray together because they were so blessed.
I understand. He's got that something
to get moved about.
What is she crying about?
I'm not doing this with you.
That's not her boyfriend. She didn't just find out her fiance isn't into God.
Right.
It's some dude out of four dudes you are currently dating.
Yes.
That he's not religious.
Before.
So you're going to cry.
Okay. Yes.
Grow up. No, you. Soon as the guys get. Soon as we get control, you're out.
I'm not doing that. saw me sober.
You had your tears.
She got a lot to pray about, which was I thought was ironic, I guess, because he's saying, you know, Ron don't want to pray about things, but you got a lot to pray about if this is what you want
to. Yeah, hopefully one of the things you got to pray about is some sense.
Liz talks about her date with David and her ex. She said it was a very intense date. David betrayed her trust in front of his friends. And over she didn't like that.
Barely on the lips. I see more intense and passionate kisses on the cheek.
From grandma.
Yo, I'm tearing the show down because of what you're about to get to.
Okay.
The way it ended is stupid.
Wait. We're not even there. We're almost there. So Tommy asked if the process ends. Listen, I will edit you out. Have a chair here.
Edit out half of your subscribers.
Get out of here. So Tommy asked if the process ends tonight, who would you leave with? Kyra and Liz say Jason. Vernicia says Joelle. Amber says Chris. And Alexis says
Jesus.
She did. Tommy made actually. Tommy said that for her. She's like, look at Amber, Alexis over there, just her and her Jesus. And she was like, I really don't know, but I did have a very passionate kiss with AJ.
She probably a freak too.
Let's move on to the final few scenes of this episode before Patrick tries to ruin it for us all. In the final few scenes of this episode, Ron,
I'm gonna do what they do. I'm gonna leave at the good part.
Okay, so Ron met up with Alexis for a date. Alexis debriefs their last date with her ex.
Ain't nothing happened.
She says she felt some kind of way. She's telling Ron this. She felt some kind of way because he was judgy and condescending, saying her ex was dripping in religion. He tells her, I don't know if you ever had divine masculinity in your household.
What?
That's what he said. Divine masculinity. He was trying to throw shade at her. And she was like, oh, you trying to say I never had masculinity in my household? You know, he was like, I never said you can't pray. I'm just saying I'm not going to be praying with y'all. Anyway, he says, you do what works for you. I'll do what works for me. He said, you can stay and pray for me, but I'm out the door handling business. They immediately get into a light argument.
Because I picked you. It was almost like you were looking for validation.
But wait a minute. So are you on this whole, I'm just picking her, or I'm saying she the one because what she could offer me, you know what I'm saying? You know, hey, I'm just saying. Hold on now. You said I can't offer you anything.
What do you mean by that?
That's the kind of stuff I'm talking about. I don't even know if you hear yourself when you're saying it. The way that you perceive yourself, it comes off like real.
Alexis is like, you know, I, you know, felt for you because you chose me as your number one, or you just chose me. And he was like, and that rubs me wrong. This is wrong because that sounds like you need validation. And she was like, well, you also like me for what I could do for you. And he was like, what can you do for me? Like, what can you? And then they started getting into it. And I'm like, yo, he's so shady. He need Chrysanthemum. Like, that's why they don't talk much. Him and Chrysanthemum. Because remember he said they don't do much talking. Yeah. They just understand each other. Because they're the same person.
Which I found hard to believe. With a jaw like that, I know he talking.
And they continue to argue. And that was the end of their scene. The scene, the final scene of this episode shows Liz meeting up with David. And she start trying to say, like, they literally sit down and she starts trying to start the conversation. And he's trying to start the conversation. And then he's like, no, let me lead. And she's like, no, you got to let me talk. No, David, let me talk. And he's like, Liz, let me talk. And then they're like,
I know you're a gentleman.
No. I know you're a gentleman. You're going to let me lead.
No, but I prefer to talk to you because.
Liz, let me explain.
No, sweetheart.
Let me talk. Lead your way right out that door. You gone.
They start getting up and standing over each other, trying to get a conversation started, and they get nowhere, and the show ends.
And then the stupid show ends.
And says to be continued. And that was the end of episode 8. We don't know who got voted off because Ron was over there
because
saying
some shady
stuff.
Because they're dragging it out to the beginning of next episode. Yeah, I feel cheated.
That's not hard, though, for him.
I feel... They are going to agree. You don't feel cheated.
I thought it was like kept you on the edge of your seat. But, you know...
Until it didn't.
Me and you watch TV different.
Look, start, middle, end.
Me and Patrick watch TV very different. Where this to me, he'd be like, this is ridiculous.
They didn't get rid of anybody.
They didn't. They didn't show nothing.
Have they had a show where they didn't get rid of anybody?
I don't think so.
They was getting rid of people at brunch. And now
I will ever let Ida live, ever. I don't know. I thought it was still interesting. And it makes me want to see what happened and see who got voted off next week. But you just so angry.
I want conclusion.
I just...
You promised somebody was going home and nobody's going home. I'm angry.
But that don't take
me. All for drama.
That's why I enjoy it. The drama. Yeah. I want to see who got... But I just feel like, Ron was shady. He was a shady little person. What can you do for me?
Finally, we're finally getting to see who they are.
Yeah. You see, David is insecure.
But what can she do for him?
Ron and Alexis?
Like, she should have been able to answer that.
I can upgrade you. Baby, how? Let me upgrade you.
By crying?
I see you beat the block, but I'm the lights to keep the streets
on. Crying for no reason?
You ain't never gonna let people.
Jesus. I'm not doing this with you. Moses. Oh my God! God! Mary.
Oh. Do you remember in the beginning of this episode he was talking about that lightning strike?
I'm talking about nobody. I'm talking about her.
I know. I'm just saying. I like this episode. I thought it was interesting. I want to see who gets voted off. I feel like the way they both go, and they ain't gonna make it into the next episode. The next full episode. That was the end of episode 8. Drop your comments in the comment section below. We would love to hear from you. Also, please like and subscribe. We are so thankful for all the support for our channel. Let us know what you think about this episode, and we will hit you right back. Join us later today for our live chat with Couples Couch at 7 p.m. So again,
because this is Saturday, it'll be on Sunday.
Right, this will be airing. Coming to America. But yes, so we will see you later in the day.
Anybody didn't know?
Aha! You gotta do that.
All night she's like, my throat is sore.
All right, I can't get to the exit or the outro or the end of the video with you.
Bye.
Thanks for watching. Bye, you guys.